which takes a little while, about an hour and a half. So XZVF because it's a GZ. So there's a patch for this, and it's one that I had to fix problems I had with compiling glibc, so I don't know how similar it is to the original patch, whatever was in that one, but it's enough changes inside it to get it compiled. With a lot of these patches, there's mentions of bugs being fixed, so whether that's a runtime bug or not, I don't know, but certainly the only patches I've managed to get or create are ones that fix compilation errors or compilation bugs. As far as runtime bugs are concerned, I'm unaware of them. But then this is purely a project to try and build this version of Linux Scratch version 4 from version 1.0. It's not something I'm going to be using in anger at all. So I'm going to run in. I'm going to do these commands one at a time because glibc is a bit of a package to deal with. Okay, what have I called this? All right, I need to change into the directory. That's better. Right, that's better. Yeah, it's quite a complicated package. So I'm just going to do a bit at a time, make sure every stage works correctly. So, change into that. So now we're going to configure it. Okay, that's it. It's not to compile with the Linux Threads add-on. Without that, the library is incompatible. Right, so the Linux Threads, I thought when I came to do this that Linux Threads was built as part of glibc, but in actual fact, in version 4.0, it's built separately as a separate package. So, it doesn't actually mention that here, does it? Oh no, it does, yeah, unpack. Right, okay, so I need to start again. Let's start right from scratch. Build. Yeah, I'm pretty sure it is actually built again for some reason later on. So let's extract this again. Okay, we need to change into it, and then it says to extract. glibc Linux Threads inside this directory, and you can see why it's called Linux Threads DB. So now I can do the patch. It's fine, touch this file and make and change into the build directory and rerun the configure, and we shouldn't have that command there now. Sorry, that warning saying that Linux Threads is not there. Okay, we add an option to the config palms, and then we build this. Like I said, I think this takes about an hour and a half, so I'll time this to see if there's any difference to when I tested this. Okay, so that's just finished at, yeah, just under an hour and a half. So I'm going to run the make install next. And I seem to remember this takes a few minutes as it has to do some more compiling or linking, as I can recall. Now I've got to install some locales. As it says here, an alternative to make locale install locales is to only install the locales which you need or want. Can be done using the local def command. Well, if you do go down that route, which is what I'm going to do, you need to create the user lib locale directory, because it won't be created for you, as it says here. Whereas running this, it will create that directory. So I'm going to do that first of all. Mkdir, paste that in. So that's done. Then I'm going to do locale def install en underscore gb minus f iso dash 8859-1 en underscore gb. And wait for that to complete. And then I'm going to repeat the same command, but to install the UTF-8 profile character set. So it's locale INGB minus F UTF-8. Then en underscore gb dot utf dash utf 8 without the dash. While that's doing, it does actually say here the Linux threads man pages are the reason why the Linux threads package is expanded later on. So that's what that is. So it looks like that's complete there. Explanations. Yeah, there's no configuration at this point. I think all the configuration of the system is done right at the very end. So that's probably part of the reason why this I have no name remains at this point. So I'm going to tidy up. Check that I haven't left any directories again. No, just the one with the extra programs I'll be installing later.